My name is Aleksandra Cichocka and I'm a lecturer in social psychology at the University of Kent. And I'm going to talk to you today a little bit about a paper that I recently published together with John Jones from New York University. The paper is entitled Stripped of Illusions, and it compares levels of support for various social political systems across countries that have traditionally been considered capitalist versus post-communist countries. Sociologists and political scientists have already noted that levels of support for the social political system in post-communist context remains very low. However, it has been really hard to come by psychological analysis of why this would be the case. So in this paper, we try to fill in this gap by analyzing social and psychological consequences and antecedents of disappointment with the status quo in post-communist countries. To do that, we use the system justification theory originally proposed by my co-author John Jost. That theory tries to explain why, how, and when people would support various social arrangements in which they function, even though doing so might sometimes work to their disadvantage. The reason why people tend to justify the social systems is that it helps them foster the belief that they live in a known and predictable environment. And such belief makes them feel generally happier and safer in their life. In our article, we summarized findings from over 20 countries to compare levels of system justification across different contexts. And what we found was that indeed, citizens of post-communist societies express lower levels of general system justification and political system justification specifically than citizens of capitalist societies. Moreover, rejection of the current social political system is associated with lower subjective well-being. At the same time, those citizens of post-communist societies who do support the social political system seem to get similar benefits as citizens of capitalist societies. So they overall reported greater happiness with their life, greater personal satisfaction, and greater efficacy with their day-to-day endeavors. So if system justification offers so many psychological benefits, why would support for the social political systems remain so low in post-communist contexts? We explored a few possibilities. First of all, some systems might simply be harder to justify than others, especially if they do not provide reassurance or predictability. In that case, however, people might satisfy their need for system justification by turning to other available social systems. In the context of post-communist countries, this could be, for example, the system of the European Union. Another possibility has to do with the cultural context. It has been shown that Central and Eastern European societies are characterized by norms of negativity, complaint, and cynicism, all of which might suppress people's readiness to overtly express support for the current social systems. So overall, we hope that our analysis will help shed more light on how people relate with their social and political realities. And this is especially important in the context of changing political systems, as we can observe in many, many countries in the world. We hope you enjoyed the paper, and please get in touch with any comments, questions, or feedback that you might have. Thank you.